What's up, y'all? It's the homie Vic getting after it once again, and today I'm talking about a very special soul that the music industry lost towards the end of 2010. Miss Teena Marie, or as some of you might like to refer to her as Lady T, again, a very gifted, incredibly talented, special artist, poet, lyricist, recorder, producer, vocalist, just all across the board, just a truly special lady. And you know, I can't say enough about what her music meant to me in my life. I'm sure if you're watching this, her music probably meant a lot to you and yours. So I'm gonna run down my list of my top 10 favorite songs by Teena Marie, and I wanna hear, what are your favorite songs? Get at me at Vic@BigVicPresents.com. It's Vic with a K. And I'm gonna just jump right in with number 10, starting with number 10 from the 1983 album Robbery, Dear Lover. Coming in at number 9 off of the 2004 CD LaDonna. Now, this was after another brief hiatus. She came back in 2004 with a little more contemporary sound. I really liked the CD, but there were really a few strong standout tracks. This one stood out enough to make my top 10 list. My Body's Hungry, and you know, if you know how Lady T could drop it, she had a kind of sex appeal to her voice, a sensuality that she could really work, particularly with songs that had a lot of what we in the business refer to as grind time. You know, when you can croon like that, you can work over that grind time, and she really knew how to do it to death. She was so creative lyrically, that combination of creativity lyrically, and then, you know, mixing that with the way she would just really lay down some smooth sensual vocals would just really do it to you, and that would do it for me. So number 9, My Body's Hungry, off the 2004 CD LaDonna.
Baby,
coming in at number 8 off of the 1980 album Irons in the Fire, which incidentally Teena Marie was quoted as saying this was her favorite album. And it's funny how, you know, music can affect you. When I hear this song, you know, it just kind of takes you back to that time, 1980. I Need Your Love. Seven, actually off of the Rick James album, the 1980 album Street Songs. You know, it's hard to think of Rick James without thinking of Teena. They were such an incredible pair. And this song in particular is interesting because, as the story goes, Teena recorded this when she was really sick. She came into the studio with a high fever, dropped her take, dropped her vocals, and immediately went straight to the hospital. So that's some dedication for you and a little bit of trivia for you. So off the 1980 Rick James album Street Songs, Fire in His Eye. Number 6 song on my list really needs no introduction, off the 1984 album Star Child, probably her biggest hit, Lover Girl.
Sugar, all I wanna do is be your one and only lover. I just want to be your
another kind of comeback from a brief hiatus, 1988 album, Naked to the World, Ooh La La La. And again, can't say enough about the lyrical creativity, the wordplay, not just creative, but and not just romantic, but deep, heavy, you know, do I thrill? Sometimes I get subliminal chills. The girl could talk that talk, go on, Teena. So off the 1988 album, Naked to the World, Ooh La La La. Coming in at number four off of the It Must Be Magic album. This is 1981, taking it back to 1981 again. I was a pretty little fella at that time, so I remember thinking this song was called Far Too Easy Love. It's actually titled Portuguese Love. Coming in at number three, and it's interesting, I didn't realize until I started putting this list together that my top three favorite songs by her are all on the same album, the 1990 album Ivory. And it just goes to show you, you know, you just never know what's going on in somebody's life at that time. I think kind of impacts how music affects you. And 1990 must have been a good year for me. I remember thinking that the album was pretty good, but there were just a few really strong standout songs, and this is one of them. Number three off of the 1990 Ivory album, It's Just Us Two. Coming in at number two, narrowing it down, again, off the 1990 Ivory album, Cupid is a Real Straight Shooter. Love that title, love that hook. Cupid is a Real Straight Shooter. Can I speak with you? My lips know nothing but your name. Number one song, my favorite song by Teena Marie, and actually one of my favorite ballads ever, all time. Again, making good use of the grind time, melodically, musically, production-wise, of course, vocally, she just did it to death. Number one off the 1990 Ivory album, If I Were a Bell. And let me tell you something, the way this lady could put it together, you know, I was talking about lyrics and sensuality. Look, as the flicker turns to flame and passion rises high, I have no choice but to carry a torch. I mean, this lady could talk that talk. You talk like that to me, you better be ready to turn down the lights. And, you know, I'm gonna keep it classy. I'm just saying, the woman knew how to flip it. So, off the 1990 Ivory album, my number one favorite song by Teena Marie, If I Were a Bell. No one could ever tell me what to think, to feel, to say, or do. Go on and talk that talk, Teena. I tell you, Lady T, you will be sorely, sorely missed. Your music will live on forever in our hearts, in our minds. And get at me. Let me know what were your favorite songs. Did I leave out something that just should have been in the top 10? I'm sure we all have different opinions about it. Let me know. Vic at BigVicPresents.com. That's Vic with a K. And share your thoughts and your memories. And we'll honor her in that way. You know, she and particularly Rick James were heavily influential to me as an artist, as a producer. So it means a lot to just come out here and respect her in this way. So that's it for me. I am Vic, the Super Producer. You are the poor soul who wasted 10 minutes of your life. I do hope you enjoyed it. And again, Teena's memory will live on forever, as she would say, till the six becomes the nine. Out.